The waterlogged ground also impacting trees in the North Metro. Take a look at this video out of Lexington. The wind bringing down several in the last 12 hours.
Yikes. Audrey Russo is joining us live from Circle Pines, where one neighborhood was completely blocked in. Audrey, what's it looking like there this morning?
Well, right now we're actually on the border of Lexington and Blaine, a different half hour. Got to show you a different tree. I want to bring this one to your attention because while some of these trees were ripped up by their roots, you can see this one was cut pretty much cleanly in half by the wind. And taking a look at some of the bark on the ground, you can see it's pretty soggy, pretty waterlogged bark here. This is one of three trees that's down in this industrial park on the Lexington-Blaine border. Now back towards Circle Pines on Hamline Avenue in that neighborhood, Alicia, that you were talking about. Yes, there were multiple trees down in different yards. Some of them were massive trees yanked up by the roots with soil everywhere. We actually spoke to one homeowner who said he had more than one tree fall down, not only on his property, but on his house. Take a listen.
There's a branch going through the roof out the side of the house. I have probably 15 trees down on this property alone, and these trees are all mature.
That homeowner tells us that he actually had to grab his kids, his grandkids, and run for cover in the basement of their house once he realized that a tree was about to fall on his property. So, of course, the cleanup effort underway there is pretty intense. They do have the streets passable at this point in the morning, though, so that's positive. We're also learning that fewer than 50 customers are without power, so they are working to get the power restored fairly quickly out there. Now, when it comes to what's causing these trees to fall over, that resident that we spoke to said many of the trees on his property were mature. Other things that can weaken trees are drought, the emerald ash borer, invasive species that can really just weaken a tree's roots, and those roots just hold on the ground because, of course, you know, when the soil gets wet, those older trees face those winds that can cause a lot of damage, as we're seeing out here this morning. Jason and Alicia, back to you.